In this problem, we want to find an equation for the rational function based upon the graph. To do this, we'll find the function in factored form, or this form here, where a is a constant, and we'll have factors in the numerator and factors in the denominator. Before we do this, let's identify some of the key components from our graph. Let's start with the intercepts. Notice how we have an x-intercept of 3, this would be the point 3, 0, and we have a y-intercept of negative 2, this would be the point 0, negative 2. Notice how we also have a vertical asymptote here, which is x equals negative 1. This is the information that we need to determine our rational function. But we do have to remember, knowing the vertical asymptote is x equals negative 1 gives us information about a factor in the denominator, and knowing that we have an x-intercept of 3 gives us information about a factor in the numerator. And then we can use the y-intercept, or this point here, to determine the value of our constant a. So let's begin to set this up. We're going to have f of x equals, we'll find a in the second step, so we'll have our constant a here. And now let's consider our vertical asymptote. Remember, vertical asymptotes are found by determining which x values make the denominator equal to 0. So if x equals negative 1 makes our denominator equal to 0, that means we must have a factor of x plus 1 in the denominator. Notice if x is negative 1, we'd have a 0 in the denominator, which would give us this vertical asymptote. Next, if we know the x-intercept is 3, 0, that means f of 3 must equal 0, meaning when x is 3, the function value is 0. Well, a rational function is equal to 0 when the numerator is equal to 0. Therefore, if we know the x-intercept is positive 3, our numerator must have a factor of x minus 3. So now we almost have our function, but we still have to find the value of a. And we can find a by using the y-intercept, or this point here. If this point on the function has coordinates 0, negative 2, then f of 0 equals negative 2. So if we substitute 0 for x, this function value must equal negative 2. So let's go ahead and do that. F of 0 would be equal to a times 0 minus 3 is negative 3, 0 plus 1 is 1. This must equal negative 2. So we have what? Negative 3a equals negative 2. Divide both sides by negative 3. And we have the value of a. A is equal to positive 2/3. Now looking back at this function here, this is the same as a times this fraction. And since a is 2/3, we can write the function as f of x equals 2 times the quantity x minus 3 divided by 3 times the quantity x plus 1. Notice how we have 2/3 times the fraction, which fits the form that we have here. We really shouldn't leave the fraction of 2/3 in the numerator. We should write it this way. This function here has all the characteristics given by the graph. Also notice that, to double check this, notice how the degree of the numerator and denominator are both 1, which means the horizontal asymptote would be the ratio of the leading coefficients, which in this case would be y equals 2/3. Looking at our graph, it does appear that our horizontal asymptote is y equals 2/3. Okay, I hope this explanation was helpful.